Hi there, my name is Igor Donko, and in this video I'll be making a review of Q-Acoustics 3020 bookshelf speakers. I have them for about 2 years now. I must say that I'm not an audio expert or anything, but I do enjoy good sound, good music, and I hope you find this review valuable. So I have these speakers for about 2 years now. When I got them, they were neatly packed in a box and protected, so there were no scratches. They have a magnetic front cover, which can be easily removed, and in terms of production value, they really seem well built. Each speaker weighs almost 5 kilos. Here is the bottom side of the speaker, where you get these rubber grips that can be firmly attached to the bottom of the speaker. And speaker really feels nice and solid, and in my opinion, for the price, the design is really good. You also get this foam, which you can insert into the backside of the speaker and decrease the amount of bass coming after the bass reflex hole. I tried it and it really works, but in my case I don't use it. My amp is a 21 years old British NAD310. It's a compact stereo amplifier which can deliver about 20 watts per channel and can be double on peaks. And even if it's old, it still works great. However, it might be a little bit weak for the speakers, but I never drive it up to maximum or anything, so I guess it should not be a problem. When testing, I will set the volume at about 35%. I'll be playing a song from NAD510 CD player, which is about the same age. I got it for my 18th birthday and it's still a pretty good CD player. And I will play a song or two from YouTube, and hopefully there won't be any copyright issues. For recording the sound, I'll be using a Zoom H1 stereo recorder at about CD quality and a little bit higher. It's placed about 2 meters from the source. And just as a side note, I learned that it is very important to move the speaker somewhat away from the wall. And it's true, because when I moved speakers a bit further from the wall, the sound did improve. And in my opinion, it kind of breathes more and it detaches from the location of the speaker. And what I also did a couple of months ago is I added a sound absorption panel, which I made myself. On YouTube you can find many do-it-yourself acoustic panel videos, and I did it because there was a slight echo in the room and I wanted to make it as neutral as possible. I think it really improved the acoustic quality of the room. Okay, finally, let's make the test. I hope the explanation was not too long, but I think it's good to know. Thank you.
put it in a bag, just like that. Best hat Yankee dollars can buy. Working on the brim, cause I like it real flat. Talking about a brand new Panama hat. It's gonna take some time. But I'm a patient guy.
After a year or so of having these speakers, I decided I will also add a subwoofer to the system and make it a 2.1 system. This is something that I always wanted to do but never had enough money to do it. Anyway, at this time I decided to purchase a small but decent sub, which I hit right here, because I didn't want to have a big black box taking space somewhere in my room, so I put it here. And because of the location, I took the model with the front firing membrane so the bass doesn't get stuck here in the corner. And it also has two bass reflex holes beneath the speaker. Placement works okay and I don't feel any distortions of sound. So this is an Italian-made Indiana Line Basso 830 model, which at the time of this video is no longer in production. It's an active 75-watt speaker with 8.6-inch membrane. It's a bit small for the subwoofer, but I took it because of its smaller size, so I could put it where I did. And I think it's also strong enough for my small flat, and for the price I paid, a bit over 220 euros, it's pretty good. And wow, this subwoofer really added an extra dimension to the sound. In my opinion, the Acoustics bookshelf speakers do produce some bass, but with a subwoofer it creates a completely different feel. It somehow adds volume and presence to the sound scene that was not there before. The point for me is not to have like a thumping bass or anything, but keep it low and subtle, just to add that presence and extra push when needed. And I can definitely recommend having an extra subwoofer. Let's give it a try. So, I hope you liked this review and you learned something new about the Q-Acoustics 3020 speaker. If you liked the video, please click like and also subscribe for future videos, because I'll be making some cool videos in the future. Thank you for watching and goodbye.